Mbele ya muhadhara huu kumkumbuka ndugu yetu Profesa Ali Mazrui. Mimi si mgeni kwa Profesa Ali Mazrui. Tokea siku zile alipokuwa yeye ni basa kule katika Mayome School, kila Ijumatano alikuwa akija Arab Secondary School across the road na akitupa lecture zake. Na sote tulikuwa tukiona ajabu kwa sababu yeye alikuwa akikisema kizungu kama vile mimi nakisema Kiswahili. Na ile wenyewe ilikuwa ni fadhila, zawadi kutoka kwa Mwenyezi Mungu. Na wako watu wengine hupewa lugha kama vile Sheikh Ali Gunda alipewa Kiarabu mpaka Waarabu wenyewe wakaona ajabu. Kwa hivyo ilikuwa ni rehema kwa Mwenyezi Mungu. Leo hii shukrani kwangu haswa ni kwa Sheikh Ali kwa alileta kutia mambo ya human rights. Na siku hizi human rights ni mambo makubwa sana. Na wengi katika wasomi wetu hapa Mombasa vile vile, kama Profesa Mohamed Haider, utaona atumia sana nafasi za kuweza kuwafunza raia wetu kujua haki zao. Ni hizi haki ambazo ni lazima tuzitake ili sisi tupate kufanikiwa. Lao utajisahau haki zako, basi ni kwenda kombo na utapelekwa kiholela, alafu italeta tabu na balaa. Leo hii mimi nasimama hapa kwa sababu haki za mtoto wangu Umar Shalo zilipotea. Alipigwa vita kwa mambo ya ardhi tu, ikawa ni holela holela, tutakatiwa moto ndani ya gari, mara tushikiwa mapanga, mambo yakaenda mpaka juu. Ndugu yangu, rafiki yangu, my playmate, mtoto wa Kigiriama ambaye tulikuwa pamoja, yeye alizaliwa mwaka ule ule 1939 September, na mimi nikazaliwa mwaka ule ule 1939 September. Playmate wangu, shamba la babangu, tukateza pamoja, lakini baadaye mambo yakaenda mrama kwa sababu pressure juu ya ardhi ilikuwa ni nyingi, na watu waanza kutukua ardhi za watu kama maembe, kama wokota. Mambo yale kaharidhishi, mjamaa yule akapigwa mapanga, mimi na Dr. Skelly tukamsaidia. Wakati mmoja tukampeleka hospitali usiku ampigwa mapanga kwa sababu yeye alikuwa ni shahidi wangu mimi katika kesi ya ardhi yangu.
Shukran bana kwa sababu
basi na... nasema hivi, mtoto wangu alikimbia, mtoto wangu alikwenda Uganda kama refugee, na nyinyi mwamjua ndugu yenu Umar Shalo, mpaka leo hii hayuko Umari. Mimi nilimfuatia ngombe Umari, turudi nyumbani babu, anambia mikatu sitaki tena kinya. Tabu zile nilizozipata zanitosha. Sijui sasa alivuka pande za Mediterranean, sijui alikwenda wapi, lakini adhandi hii na haki zetu ni lazima tuzipiganie kisheria. Kisheria. Maanake hapa tukitaka kuketi sisi katika nchi hii, hatukuninoletwa hapa kama mahamali, ni kwetu. Na wewe kumva kanzu au wewe umva ubinda wa kibaniani, hapa ni kwenu. Asante sana.
Shukran, shukran, shukran. Naitwa Rukia, Vice Chair Chamber of Commerce. Yangu ningependa kumuomba Vice Chair wa umma na Bwana CJ watusaidie kwa serikali, either TUM University ama any of one of our universities zipewe jina la almarhum Professor Mazrui. Hilo ni jambo ambalo tume ulizwa hapa, na I think it's something which can be discussed in other forums. It's a very good idea, but as you know, most of these universities, they are public universities, so there are processes that have to be followed. So, but the idea is good.
and we'll take it up. Anybody else with another question, comment? But I also wanted to remind the members here that at Technical University of Mombasa, we actually have dedicated one of the newly built Faculty of Science building, and we have named it after the late Professor Ali Mazrui. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Allahumma salli ala kulli khairin mimman nurid wa najina kulli sharrin mimman nakhaf. Mimi naitwa Juma Shabani, natoka Likoni. Kidogo langu litanijia kwa mheshimiwa Justice Sir Justice Chief Sir Justice. Mimi na kilio kidogo ambacho nafikiri ni cha umamzima Mombasa. Koti yetu ya Mombasa hii ni koti ya pili katika Jamhuri ya Kenya. Ni koti ambayo ina shughuli nyingi za kitaifa na za kimataifa. Mheshimiwa Chief Justice, kulikuwa majaji 9 walitolewa Mombasa hapa. Na hatujui lini majaji wale wataletwa Mombasa hapa. Kwa sababu shida ni kwamba Mombasa leo makesi mengi yamekuwa dated. Mimi mwenyewe na kesi imenirudia mara 3 juzi. Jana nimerudi pale pia ikawa kesi yangu imepunguzwa sababu majaji ni kidogo, kesi ni nyingi. Hili swala pia tuliuliza tena hapa, tumepata fursa hii na tunauliza kwamba hao majaji wale ambao wametolewa Mombasa High Law Court watarudishwa lini ili tupate zile nafasi ambazo leo tusumbuka na makesi yetu ziwe zitarudi pale. Alahi sallahu bihakamil hakimin.
Shukran, shukran. Hilo ni swala zuri na bwana CJ umesikia watu wa Mombasa wanaicho kilio. Majudges wanaondoshwa from Mombasa, they are being transferred, and I don't know whether you will be able to respond. Maybe do you want to respond to that? Or
I think it's good that he asked that question, because he might have signed that petition collecting signatures for my removal, which the lawyers the lawyers are collecting, but let me say that the problem we have with the Mombasa lawyers is that at least the leadership, they say I'm taking lawyers out of Mombasa, judges and magistrates, and that Mombasa is being marginalized, which is not true. I haven't even bothered to respond to it, because you don't respond to lies. When I was appointed Chief Justice, Mombasa had only three judges. We also, as Muslims, as you know, we had only Sheikh Ahmad. How many Qadis did we have? No, I mean in the country. We had 17 Qadis in the country, and the Chief Qadi Ahmad, if you ask him, he didn't even have a vehicle, right? You served for many years, no vehicles. We were able to make sure that the Chief Qadi and the Deputy Chief Qadi have vehicles. And we also made sure that the Qadis were not discriminated, because every Qadi now has the status of a magistrate. The Chief Qadi has the status of a Chief Magistrate. The terms and the conditions are better. And instead of 15, we increased them to Qadis to 35, and now we have 20 more. And we're also looking at the assistant Qadis so that they can be part of the, part of the judicial system. But as far as judges are concerned, there were only 3. And now they have 7. And then we have a judge in Voi, you know, and they say that is marginalization. No, the judge in Voi is supposed to decongest Mombasa. And the people from Taita Taveta don't have to come to Mombasa. They can go to Voi. Why are they against judges, the judge we appointed in Tana River? And another judge is coming to Kwale, okay? And we are going to have an admiralty judge in Mombasa as well. So there's no marginalization. And let's not forget that NFD, that corridor, kutoka nani, Turukana and Garissa, there were no judges. Now we have a judge in Kapenguria, we have a judge in Lodwar, we have a judge in Garissa and Marsabit. If you are talking about marginalization, it's marginalization in those areas, the forgotten people in NFD. We're looking at data to make sure that judges are distributed, you know, along the counties and whatnot. 2011, there were only 17 judges in 17 counties. Now we have judges in 34 counties, and by next year, inshallah, we will have a judge in every, you know, in every county. Environment and land. They are saying that cost has a lot of land problems. The entire country has land problems. And we have only 15 environment and land judges. Mombasa has 2. Nairobi has 3. And the other 10 are shared, you know, across the country. So, on what basis would I marginalize Mombasa anyway? Why? So I'm glad my brother asked that question so that I can clarify it, because I don't intend to debate Nyongesa and the others, because if I did, I'll start telling truths about him. As far as the judges are concerned here, you know, I'm sure that case was adjourned because we have a colloquium at White Sands this week, and that's why the cases were not heard. So I've said my piece, and if you think I'm lying, just go and sign the petition. I'll defend myself whenever it comes up.
Thank you, Bwana CJ, for clarifying and shedding light on this contentious issue. But I know you are saying that this is a common problem throughout our country. Lakini unajua kila mmoja huwa anavutia kwake. As we are thinking about our problems here at the coast and not the other people's problems. So, but it was good that you clarified that the problem is throughout our country. I think that will be now the last question. That will be the last question. And being a lady, I wanted the plenary session to end with a lady's comment or question.
Salamu alaikum. Kwa majina naitwa Jena Dea, natoka Mombasa. Mimi swali langu wa shida langu, nashukuru sana kwa hii memory ya tuseme kama babangu Ali Mazrui. Maana yake alivotoka ngambo sisi tuliwahi kuonana naye akiwa na balala alivokuwa hajakuwa mbunge hapa Lofo Hotel. Sasa swali langu laja hivi kwa Chief Justice, bado sisi tuenda kwa sheria. Mimi shida yangu bwana Chief Justice mmoja. Nafikiri katika wakati ukitaka kuchaguliwa Chief Justice, nilikuwa nafikiri mwanamke wa kwanza kukongratulate. Watu wakisema vipuli sijui nini, sisi tulikutaka uwe kama raia. Sasa najua uweza kuwa ofisini juu, hapa chini hujui kuendelea nini. Hii koti yetu ya Mombasa ina shida sana. Na shida iliyoko unasema ni kama kwa serikali. Kuna brokers pale kotini. Kuna majaji, majama, magistrate na mabrokers wao. Utapata mtu ameshikwa labda hajafanya kosa. Wajua kuna yule amefanya na kuna yule hajafanya. Na waambua paka proof guilt. Sasa wameenda kotini, mtu amesomwa shtaka, amelikataa, hajafanya ile nani. Punde si punde tu kizunguka ta kutoka utapata kuna broker akikuchukua, utamuona magistrate ama majaji. Ile kesi haitachukua muda mrefu ukiwa mfuko wako uko sawa. Utaachiliwa. Na yule aliyodhulumiwa atazidi kudhulumiwa. Ndio hayo alimfanya ndugu yetu marehemu Profesa Mazrui akafaitia haki ya binadamu mpaka akakimbia Kenya akaenda kuishi uhamishoni. Na akarudi na hakukaa sana na Mwenyezi Mungu akamchukua. Na kama kweli ni Waislamu mimi ni Mkristo, tunataka kufaitia haki. Ianze na makotini. Maanake mnafunga walio ambao hawajafanya kosa na yule aliyofanya kosa yuko nje kwa vile yeye ni tajiri. Hii nataka uchunguze. Nasema mara ya kwanza nafikiri kuna wakati tulikutana na wewe na wenzetu ambao tunafaitia ulivyokuja kwa shughuli zako tukakueleza. Na hii kitu haijaisha Mombasa. Kwenye corridor ya Mombasa pale broker ni wengi, ulanguzi wa kesi ni wengi sana. Na tusemi kuwa majaji wajui, nifika ambaye wanawatuma. Through them because kuna watchdogs wale ndio wanapeleka nini kule. Tunaomba jamani wale wenye kufungwa wengine hajafanya. Maana kuna kesi moja nasema tukisema kama leo uifuatilizie. Watchman anashikwa na vile tokea pa kwenye magazeti. Container patikana ya pembe za ndovu chuda imekuwa sealed. Mimi ni watchman mlinda geti na kulinda ile nyumba. Mimi ndio naenda uza shimoletewa mwenye mali hajashikwa mpaka leo haijulikani ya nani. Lakini ule watchman mwenye alipo 1500 kwa mwezi ndio yuko chimbolatiwa. Je, yuko haki huo jaji hata kama aliletwa na polisi? Hawezi ona tofauti ya watchman na mwenye mali. Angalia hiyo kesi.
Thank you very much. Our master of ceremonies, my distinguished brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullah.
I want first of all to thank Umma University and the Aga Khan Foundation and all the brothers and sisters who worked very hard to bring us together today to remember our distinguished brother, the late Professor Ali Mazrui. Thank you very much. I have not read the Kenyan Constitution, so I am not about to attempt to make comments about it. But sitting there and listening to the discussions and my knowledge of the late Professor Mazrui, a few questions were going on in my mind. Number one, how come that we have only had one person in all these years who have risen to that level of international recognition? What happened? We have only had one Ali Mazrui at that rank of intellectual discourse, academic excellence, human rights, no, cutting across all sectors of human society. And yet, he exemplified the power of the intellect in changing opinions, in directing efforts and energies to worthy causes of humanity. How come we don't have many more of these Mazruis? Then the other question is, how can we begin the process that will give us many Ali Mazruis so that in our memorial lectures, when we bring the 5 of them or 10 of them to discuss whatever social challenge the world may be facing, you really get intellectual discourses and come up with solutions that probably can guide human endeavors to a better way of living. We need to find a mechanism. And finally, by looking at the history of the late Professor Mazrui, his educational background, studied in an Arab school, went to UK, Manchester, Columbia, and then back to Oxford. Where is our Manchester and where is our Oxford in Africa? Where we can graduate people of this caliber? My message to you, brothers and sisters, is we need to invest a lot in the education of our children, in quality educational institutions and schools, if we are going to have more Mazruis. These children all over Mombasa, all over Africa, in Kampala, everywhere, they need to be given a fair chance to excel in their academic careers. And quality education is not cheap. Quality education is not cheap. I know as a Muslim community, all over the world, we are not investing sufficiently in quality education. And that is one of our makings. I will give you a simple example. South Korea alone publishes more articles than the whole of the 57 member states of the OIC put together. What happened? Why? Is it because that we don't have any more bright children? No. The bright children are there, but we are not giving them a fair chance to succeed in life. And when it comes to female education, that is even worse. Muslims, we have that weakness of neglecting the girl child when it comes to providing opportunities for education. There has never been a community or a nation that can develop on a sustainable basis if it leaves 50% of its children behind. So please, the Muslims, we still have a lot of work to do to provide quality schools, quality teachers, quality curriculum that will produce more Mazruis of the future. And we should work together in making that possible. It is possible, it is doable. And here in Mombasa and Kenya, there are more rich Muslims in Kenya than in Uganda. And in Mombasa, we want a Harvard here. Create a Harvard, create an Oxford here. And then we can have many more people to celebrate as we move forward. Thank you very much. The Islamic University in Uganda has produced many people, some of them are working in Uma University, and many from Mombasa. We are proud to make that little contribution. And we want to work with you to make it even greater. We need to have a holistic approach. We have shortages of human resources in every sector that you can look at. The Chief Justice, when he's looking for Muslim lawyers, he could probably not find many with masters and PhD. Take your boys to do masters and PhD in law and go to his door and say, he is my son. He has a PhD in constitutional law, in land and environmental law. And then maybe he will be appointed to be the judge in Mombasa. Now in IUIU, we have started medicine. Alhamdulillah, we have nursing. We are working on engineering, dentistry, and pharmacy. The 21st century, living and working in the 21st century, demands different skills and especially thinking skills for our children and science and technology. We can't be absent, we can't compete on the global scene if we don't have a critical mass of scientists and technologists and engineers and medical doctors. Thank you very much, Madam Chairperson. Sorry for disorganizing your program. Salaam alaikum.
Thank you, Professor Sengedo. You couldn't have said it any better. The best inheritance that we can give our children is education. Nothing less than that. So if you want our society to change, the only way it will change is through education. And it was good that I allowed the last speaker so that he could actually say it all. Now, just as a follow-up to the issue that was raised by our sister, I would like to call upon Brother Salim Galgani from Mewa, the chairman of Mewa, and I think he has some good news for us. So let us hear what he has to tell us.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته وعليكم السلام وجودي مشكورة Chief Justice Professor Shapalgai Nowrojee President of Khan Professor Shaukat وجودي مشكورة Nina furaha sana alhamdulillah kupata fursa hii. This is a golden opportunity to speak before professors, high scholars like yourself. Wallahi, it's a very big privilege for me. It's an honor. Thank you very much. I'll be very brief. The good news which I wanted to share. First, I want to acknowledge what Professor Ahmed had said from my Islamic University of Uganda. I remember we met some time back, we came for a seminar and we invited him to come to Mewa. If you remember, that was some time back. Indeed, we still have bright students. Our mothers and our sisters and our wives are still giving birth to such. The only problem is that, and they have a lot of energy, a lot of passion, but it is misplaced. That has been the problem for our people in our society. The energy which is there is misplaced, and you know what I mean. Instead of it being used positively somewhere, it is being used negatively, and it is draining us and the society at all. Wallahi, education is paramount, and that is the reason how Mewa was formed, a fundamental of education. Just by its name, Mewa is Muslim Education and Welfare Association. Today, when we mention Mewa, people are seeing the hospital. We kind of drifted a bit because there is need for us to do that into medical a bit, but alhamdulillah, the few who have benefited from Mewa in terms of education, one of them being our brother, Allah wa mahfadi, our senator, Hassan Sarai. He's a product of Mewa. He is proud to say so, that he's been educated and helped by Mewa until we reach where he has reached. And there are many others. Commissioner Murshid, who is actually a vice chair of the Commission for Vetting the Officers, among many others. But for some reason, we drifted a bit, and we regret for that. But inshallah, watch this space, we are coming back. And this is the reason why we're here today, to celebrate the life of our Mu'allim, Professor Ali Mafir. The good news is, Alhamdulillah, thumma Alhamdulillah. Before I share that good news, I'll say, I remember one ayah in the Quran. It's a long ayah, but A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem says, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusih. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never change, will not change the condition of a people until they change in themselves first. Alhamdulillah, we at Mewa have a vision to bring back this society to its vision and the ideology of educating. As I have been instructed by our Prophet, when we had got the first ayah, Ikra. Alhamdulillah, today we had a very important visitor, CJ visited us, and Professor Alamin. We have a library, state-of-art library. We were going to give it a name, and we have found a precise name. Takbir. Can you guess what the name is? Can you say it aloud? What is the name of our new library? Professor Ali Mazrui Memorial Library. Takbir. we want to actually use that as a platform for our youth to be able to understand what our scholars like Professor Al-Mazrui and others who are also being forgotten, and want to create a corner and a special center, a resource center, so that our youth can come back and understand how these people actually came up and be able to reach where they have reached, the climax of their career. So indeed, inshallah, this is the great news which I wanted to share. It's an achievement for us. And we have been asked to take 2 minutes, but I wanted to actually thank the family of late Ali Mazrui for accepting this, an honor for us as Mewa, Mewa Executive Committee Board and his trustee, to be able to have been answered and accepted to use his name for our facility. Because we cannot just get to use anybody's name without somebody be able to measure up to that standard. And I hope, inshallah, through our Professor Ali Al-Amin and CJ, they are able to come today at our library to do what maybe I can call a due diligence assessment. I hope we have been able to achieve that standard for our center, our library, to be called so, inshallah. And we are lucky today to receive the first batch of the books which were done by Professor Ali Mazrui, Barakallahu Fik, Professor Al-Amin, and CJ, Dr. Willy Mutunga. The books which you have received, we are going to put them in a special corner together with other writings which were done by the professor and other things. Alhamdulillah, Mzewangu, Professor Al-Amin, he was, I think, very much in touch and was impressed. He said, we are going to work with you and establish a resource center. Takbir. So that is the message. I don't have much to say. I hope the center will inspire these youth, Dr. Ahmed. Inshallah, they will come, they will learn, and we'll have more of Ali Mazrui from that center, inshallah. Together with the team and together with the Umma University, we work together. I want to end my talk by actually advising that we, as I said, we want to change the negative which is within our society into positive with the young ones, and the best you can give to a scholar like Professor Mazrui, as they say, there's a saying from John Ruskin who says, the highest reward for a person's toil is not what they get for it, but what they become by it. And this is what has become by of a Professor Mazrui. Kwa haya mengi, inshallah, ni mwamba Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, atupatie tawfik. Now I'm challenging and I'm requesting and challenging all those people, the family of Ali Mazrui, his friends, his students, and all those people who like Professor Mazrui, to take a challenge and come and visit our center. We welcome any contribution of any kind, any suggestion, to make it actually the epic of our institution in this part of the world. Kwa haya mengi, naomba inshallah, if mekosea kidogo mtanisameh, but this is me, and I hope inshallah, Brother CJ, the connection which you have made today should not be lost. Professor Al-Amin, inshallah, takuomba uje tena na wengine tuweze kuimake that center a success. Wa hadha, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Barakallahu fiku wa jazakumullah khair wa afwa minkum.
Thank you, Brother Salim. Thank you for the good news. My sister from the Kenya National Chamber of Commerce. But before I do that, I want also to call upon Simon Otieno, who's the outgoing head of Aga Khan Academy.
Thank you very much for allowing me this opportunity to speak to the distinguished members of the panel here and all the scholars who are here, members of the Mazrui family, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Aga Khan Academy. As just has been mentioned, I am the outgoing head of the school. I've been in this school since 2006 and has seen this school move from stage to stage. I joined this school from St. Mary's School in Nairobi. I stopped being the head on 31st of August, and the new head of school is Mr. Bill O'Han, who I will ask to stand so that at least you are able to see him. That's Mr. Bill O'Han is taking over from me. I will, however, continue to work with this distinguished organization and school on a very different capacity. Mr. CJ, you can rest easy. There won't be a question for you. There won't be something for you to answer from me. I just want to mention that this school, the Aga Khan Academy in Mombasa, was opened on December 20th, 2003, as the very first school of a network that will be 18 schools spread throughout Africa, Asia, South Asia, Central Asia, and the Middle East. 18 schools in total in the developing world. This was the very first one. The second school has already been inaugurated, and it is functioning in Hyderabad, India. The third of these schools, part of the network, is also open for business now in Maputo, Mozambique. That happened last year. As is well known, the Aga Khan has run schools in many parts of the world for more than a century now. 240 schools altogether. That gives a tremendous experience in education. We indeed know very well about the Aga Khan High School right here in Mombasa, and we also know about the one in Nairobi. Many others are situated in Kisumu, in Eldoret. 11 schools, institutions all together in Kenya only. In that way, His Highness the Aga Khan has favored Kenya in a very special way, up to and including starting the first of the academies here. Other schools are also there in Dar es Salaam, and there is also the school in Kampala. Of the network, 4 more schools will be functional by 2017. There will be 1 school in Dar es Salaam. There will be the school in Bishkek. There will be school in, there will be school in Bishkek. There's a school in Dhaka, and the last school in Lisbon. So in the next few years, there should be another 4 in that category. At the inauguration of this school on December 20th, 2003, His Highness the Aga Khan distinguished the type of school that the Aga Khan Academy Mombasa, and indeed the network, will be like. He said this: "The citizens of Africa must function intellectually at the highest international levels. Their writings and research must contribute to the global edifice of knowledge. The economists, the lawyers, physicians, and scientists must participate easily in the professional and scientific societies around the world, and that their publications, inventions, and artistic and architectural creations must be of the quality that enrich the human experience." This is not a simple thing, And the reality is that it's a difficult task which is being realized today in Kenya. Knowing that Professor Mazrui was listed among the world's top 100 most influential thinkers, His Highness the Aga Khan was likening the outcome or the alumni of the school to Professor Mazrui, to people of that intellectual caliber. The difference between this school and many other Aga Khan schools that we have experienced is that it is part of this network of co-educational schools, all of them that are going to be residential. These schools will always be from pre-primary to the secondary school. They will offer an international level of education. At this moment, our school has decided as a choice to offer the international baccalaureate. They will offer an intense leadership development experience. And therefore, throughout the time that we are teaching the children who pass through our school, that is a concentration that we have. There will be schools that will be merit-based and needs-blind. So we have got several students that we have brought into the school from all over the communities, especially the community around the coast, who are here because of their merit, and that they will develop the quality of, they will have the responsibility to develop the quality of educators. Teachers in this school surely go through a lot of professional development, a thing which most of the country now is in short supply of. We've mentioned about the discomfort with excellence. This is an institution that is embracing excellence. Competence is indeed welcome around here, and it is not at all considered a burden in this institution. Someone asked the reason for the shortage of intellectuals in our Kenya today. The people are the same, but perhaps our curriculum may be playing a very big role in hampering and impeding the growth of people. We need a curriculum that is much more open, and that is the kind of curriculum that we offer at this school. Anytime you organize an event, you expect people to come. And you have come to this particular event that we have had here. So I thank you very much for being here. Thank you.
Thank you, Bwana Simon. We are now coming to the end of our lecture. And I would like now to call upon our brother, Abdul Hamid Slash, from the International Institute of Islamic Thought, to give a vote of thanks. And then we'll have a tea break and networking. Finally, guests will leave at their own pleasure. So take advantage of the networking. It's not every day that you are able to meet our members of the panel here. So if you have any other burning issue, you can always be able to talk to them during the
Dear friends and colleagues, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. I've been given the task to move a vote of thanks. But when I was sitting and thinking and reflecting on it, I was wondering, how can I thank Professor Yash Ghai, who was colleague and a classmate to late Professor Ali Mazrui? How can I thank Dr. Willy Mutunga, who adopted him as his jombo? And my ustad, Mr. Pheroze, Nowrojee, who's been colleagues and working together. But having said that, the protocols have to be followed, and I'll try my best. But before I do that, I just want to share one or two incidents which will reflect on late professor's character. I met him first time in 2003 in Kampala during an Islamic Civilization conference. After his lecture, I went looking for him because I wanted to greet him. I met him in the reception and went and greeted him with salams and talked to him in English. He looked at me and he said, "Where are you from?" I said, "From Kenya." I was embarrassed. Then we sat down for a cup of tea and started. But that sent a very strong message to me. You know, his vision and his work on the culture and languages. Thereafter, when we all started moving towards the agitation of the new constitution, early 1998, he visited Nairobi. When he was in Mombasa, my brother Munir Mazrui, the elder brother of Professor Alameen Mazrui, called me because I was with Supcam at that time. He said, "Mazrui is here. Can we organize a lecture for him on the constitution?" So why not? I got excited. I talked to brothers. I talked to other friends. We hired Pan-African Hotel Hall. And in order to mobilize, I sent a message to the Muslim Students Union of University of Nairobi. And then I sent another message to my friend and colleague, Mr. Davinder Lamba, from the NGO Council. I tell you, when he came in there, the hall was overflowing, there was no place, the staircases, everything was taken over by the young people who wanted to hear him. So that tells us that how popular and how wanted he was amongst the youth and the Kenyans. Now, with IIIT, which is the International Institute of Islamic Thought, he came on board middle of 80s. Probably I don't have the exact year, but I was told it's 1984, 1985. With late Professor Ismail Farooqi Raji, who some of you if know, he was brutally murdered in USA because of his works. They started talking, working on integration of knowledge and integration of cultures at that time. And they moved on. Then Professor Dr. Abdul Hamid Abu Suleiman, who is the current president of IIIT, joined them. And from there, the things started taking shape into an Islamic vision. And slowly but surely, the programs of Islamization started working. And I'm very happy to note and then also follow up some of his writings and teaching that during his late time, he started writing on Islamization of knowledge, Islamization of culture, Islamization of attitude, so many other articles which were written. And alhamdulillah, all his works and his work with this reverity, he has donated to the IIIT library in New York with a request to those people that they should be availed to all or everyone who wants to do career research and they want to have access to his works. It is there, so anybody who wants to, you know, read or visit his works, you can go on to the Google, www.IIIT.org, and go to the library, you'll get his works, inshallah. Now I go on to the job which I've been given to move a vote of thanks. We could not have this function if our elders, Professor Yash, Ghai, Dr. Willy Mutunga, Pheroze Nowrojee, had not consented and given their time from their very, very busy schedules. Some of them have just traveled from overseas and joined us. Those have been left their offices and other work to join us here. So they were the key figures here for our program. Thank you very much, sir. You are most welcome. I want to move a vote of thanks to His Highness Aga Khan's Shia Imamiyah Council through President Nawaz Ghulam, who worked tirelessly to get us these facilities, and his volunteers here who very elegantly served you with lunch. Thank you very much, sir. And I hope the cooperation will continue in the future. I also want to thank the family of late Professor Ali Mazrui, my brother, my colleague, Sheikh Hamad Muhammad Qasim, Professor Al-Amin Mazrui, and my brother who is recovering, who is sick, Munir Mazrui. We have worked a long way. Thank you very much, family, and Jazakallah Khair for giving us this honor to host this function. I also want to take this opportunity to thank my other friend and brother, Dr. Ahmed Sangendo, who traveled all the way from Kampala to attend this function. Thank you, Ahmed. You're welcome. The next function of Mazrui will be in your university, inshallah. I also want to thank my committee under the chairmanship of Professor Abdul Razak and ably, logistically, President Gharib. Please, Gharib, please, can you stand up, please? Where are you? Gharib Tamim. He really worked very hard for the success of this function. Thank you very much. And all of you who are present here, it wouldn't have been possible without your presence. I think you need a clap. Please give yourself a clap. Thank you. And lastly, but not the least, I don't know, I think exhausted all here. Is there anybody left, Prof? Jazakallah khair. And thank you. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave us this opportunity to be together, and we pray for the maghfirah for our marhum brother. Allahumma rahmahu wa rahmatuhu wa rahmatuhu. Inshallah, Allah will place him in Jannah, in the most precious people of his life because of his work. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brother Abdul Hamid. Now, I just wanted to remind our distinguished guests that there will also be a guided tour of the Aga Khan Academy by Brother Ghulam Juma. And since we started off with a prayer, I also want us to close with a prayer from Sheikh Talib, from who is the Qadhi
of Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wassalamu ala sayyidina wa sallam.